shabby shows.
Well, not the wizards.
Whales are held in captivity against their will. How did all of this orca captivity started? It all started in the 60s. SeaWorld San Diego got its first orca in 1965. They named it Shamu. Let's learn some history, okay? In 1970, more than 90 orcas were stocked and herded at Puget Sound, Washington. This led to a lifetime of captivity and abuse of orcas in marine parks and aquariums around the world. Young calves were torn from their mothers. The orcas were sent to SeaWorld to perform and die in tiny cement pools. In Puget Sound between 1970 and 1971, 10 orcas were captured from their ocean homes. Half of those were sent to SeaWorld. Some only survived a few months. All died prematurely, which is also like a teenager, with the exception of Lolita, who still lives at the Miami Seaquarium. During the 15 years of capture in Washington and British Columbia, 275 to 307 whales were caught. 55 were transferred to aquariums, 12 or 13 died during capture operations. There are currently a total of 56 orcas killed in captivity, 23 wild captured plus 33 captive born in at least 12 marine parks in 8 different countries. To be in captivity for a wild orca is very stressful and unnatural. When they are in captivity, they show a very strange behavior. Most captive male whales and some females have a dorsal fin that is partially or completely collapsed to one side. This is due to the poor health of the whales. Limited swimming space, stress, and warmer water temperatures can cause their fins to collapse over. Orcas kept in cramped spaces can develop violent and/or psychotic behavior. There are no records and free-ranging orcas killing or seriously injuring people. In contrast, there have been many dangerous incidents between humans and captive orcas, including trainers killed by orcas at SeaWorld parks. Scientists say orcas in captivity usually only live up to 25 years. While their average lifespan in the wild is 50 to 80 years, with females living up to 100 plus years. That's a lot! Earlier pregnancies among orcas led to a higher percentage of young calves dying. The stress of captivity causes them extreme oral health problems. Often, orcas will bite down on the horizontal metal bars in their enclosure to demonstrate aggression and to trying to escape, which causes broken teeth and dental problems. Orcas are incredibly social creatures who travel with family in pods or in groups of up to 40 whales. In captivity, they are normally held on a tank with only a couple of other whales not from their herd or liking. They get into fights and they can't run away as if they would do in the wild. Whales that are kept in chlorinated tanks have similar effects to humans living in chlorine water, such as the harsh chemicals irritate their skin and eyes, leaves them dry. Also, since the depth of the tank is not deep, they suffer from constant sunburn. To cover the burns, SeaWorld uses black zinc oxide to cover up the marks of existing burns. Who does that? SeaWorld San Diego's current show pool for orcas is 36 feet deep, 180 feet long, and 90 feet wide, nowhere near the depth of an orca will dive into the wild. Orcas have been recorded to dive in the depths of 853 feet. The small blue box in the upper middle of this picture shows the total amount of space in the largest orca tank at SeaWorld. The yellow line shows the path of the dive by free orca from the southern resident population. Here are some organizations that help orcas. WDC, which is Whale Dolphin Care, PETA, and PETA 2. If you want to know more about the truth about orcas, some documentaries that you can watch are Blackfish, that is very successful and available on Netflix, All From Freedom, The Whale, also available on Netflix. Thank you for listening on my presentation. I hope this information was inspirational and raises awareness about orcas in captivity. I used to go to SeaWorld a bunch, but now that I know the truth, I said, no way, Jose. Unless SeaWorld changes, I don't plan on going back to support animal abuse because I am an animal lover.